handy resource indeed, your field guide.
Confringo! Accio! Alohomora! Lumos. Revelio. Revelio.
An astronomy table should prove useful once the sun's down. Here's one of those tables Professor Shaw mentioned.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented...
Alohomora. Levioso! Alohomora. Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio. 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 Levioso. Revelio. Accio. Revelio. Accio. Revelio.
I adore the hamlets near the coast. They're ever flat, but ever so picturesque.
I adore shopping in Hogsmeade.
Revelio. Revelio.
got here then, eh?
Alohomora. Confringo!
I like to keep a bit of wind.
Lumos.
I'm not ready for the big thing.
Alohomora. Lumos.
I need to catch up on my letter writing. I think my owl's going to collapse. I don't think owls make very good pets. You can't just run away.
Alohomora. Levioso. Revelio. Levioso. Revelio. Revelio.
Throughout the many goblin battles, countless wizard cloaks were lost. Actually, we do know the number. 632. But history occurs outside the classroom. And look, it's time for my constitutional. One can practically osmose the history flowing through Hogwarts.
I think the professor wants us to follow him.
And now for a stroll to the bell tower entrance hall. Along with the rest of the castle, it was completed in the late early Middle Ages. The hall and the bell towers that loom above it contain myriad interesting artifacts. Good to see you again. Recovered from that nasty bout of dragon pox, have we?
That wasn't me, Professor. I'm new here.
Are you? Well then, welcome. No doubt you're eagerly anticipating my analysis of various wizarding councils, codes, statutes, and of course, goblin rebellion. Not all goblins are rebellious. Some venture into wizarding politics, such as Irgit the Ugly. Some are talented artisans, such as Bragbor the Boastful.
Did you say Bragbor? I know that name. Lord Gok said he was an ancestor of Ranrok.
Well known for his metalwork. I would imagine much of his goblin wrought iron and silver has survived to this very day. Where were we? Oh yes. Back to our class topic for today. Grimbold Weft, another notable historical figure. He's right nearby.
Revelio.
Oh yes, I see you found Grimbold Weft.
Yes, I rather enjoyed seeking him out.
The thrill of the scholarly pursuit. I know the feeling quite well. Now, let's turn our attention to the agreeability and general good nature of Sir Aphbuddle. He's also nearby. See what you can learn from him for your next assignment.
Revelio.
Standing in eternal but symbolic watch over the bell tower is a retinue of loyal knights, or rather, statues. His fame was not won by vanquishing foes and
abandoning class to wander the...
Professor Binns, I found the statue of Sir Aphbuddle.
Ah, well done. Alas, Sir Aphbuddle's affability was his undoing. Died instantly trying to befriend a basilisk. Eye contact is not always to be encouraged. So beloved was he that even some goblins mourned his passing. Of course, that did not bode well with the rest of the goblins, most of whom could not abide mourning the loss of a wizard.
Pity goblins and wizards can't get along.
True. But imagine how dull my lectures would be without goblin rebellions to discuss. History does tend to repeat. It is a series of patterns, a thought both comforting and disconcerting. The wise student, such as yourself, will learn from it.
Thank you.
Accio. Huh?